Today's video will be about Columbus. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all members and subscribers. Today I will have a look at Jarunis latest video. It's from a live show he chosen a part and he calls the video Columbus Maps.
What was with the lie with Columbus? Like, did nobody notice this lie was going on when we were in school? Why did it have to wait until Flat Earth starts coming out? Like, oh, actually, he never did think the Earth was flat. He actually, you know, he got it from this author. This author perpetuated this hoax. It's just garbage. It's just nonsense.
I don't know about schools in US, but when I went to school long time ago, I have passed 50 years old, so it's a long time ago, we did learn that Columbus did go west to find a shorter way to India. So he did know that we live on a globe.
Because why were they teaching us all that? Nobody reviews the lesson plans first and says, actually, you know, Columbus never thought that it was flat. But again, they love to basically indoctrinate you with that. And then when we get to this age, now they're saying, oh, no, actually, it was a big hoax. And no, we've known the Earth was a sphere for 2,000 years, 2,300 years. I think they like
that. Yeah, if you actually read Irving's way book, far away. Really funny.
And do you think Irving's that it's book... true that his book pushed that idea?
Irving's book had Columbus where he was talking about, he was worried about people falling off the edge of a globe. That was his whole thing. Not off the edge of a flat earth, he was worried about people falling off the edge of a globe. And that was all written into his book.
So Kyle Adams thinks that Christopher Columbus was afraid for falling over the edge of a globe. Yes, it's sometimes claimed that Christopher Columbus' men were terrified of joining him on the voyage across the Atlantic in 1492 because they thought they would fall over the edge of the Earth. This is a myth originates from 1829 biography Washington Irving's The Life and Voyage of Christopher Columbus. Irving was primarily a writer of fiction inspired of folklore, but some have misunderstood the book and regard it as a piece of a reliable biography. But it's not. He didn't make any research. He have never met Columbus. In fact, the scholars of Columbus days were not debating whether the Earth was a globe or not, but how big the globe was and whatever man was able to sail far enough with the provisions that they would fit on sailing ship of those times.
Wow.
It was just really funny. It's like, yeah.
And I think if I've looked at the Columbus map before, I know that they've... No, I meant Christopher Columbus. I've seen it before, and I think that they try and lie to us and tell us... So the Christopher Columbus map is this one here, I believe. And they try and pretend that this is supposed to be depicting a globe. I don't think it is. I think that they probably thought back then that it was flat.
And once again, a flat earther that don't understand the need of map projections. How do you draw a globe on a flat paper, Jarunism?
It looks like a flat earth map to me.
Again, and what's the first globe that ever came onto the scene? 1492. It's the oldest globe that we have, which is insane because if Aristophanes measured it in 300 BC, then you're talking about 1700 years. Think of how long your life has been. You've been here 30, 40, 50 years. Think of 1700 years that went by until somebody said, you know what? Since the Earth is a sphere, let's map it on a sphere.
Are he really this stupid? Of course he is. How much of the world did they know about at that time? Who? Oh, they are so stupid.
Guess nobody thought of that for 1700 years. That's pretty crazy. Pretty crazy.
Pretty hard to believe.
I'm actually
the weird thing about
map.
The Columbus map is that I've been scratching my head on is, if I were to draw an equator on that, what would it look like?
Oh, this is the one I'm talking about. So look at this map here. Let me bring this up if I can get it. Hopefully it's one of those you can zoom in on, and it's download. Okay.
Oh, just crazy, because I was here and think about it. It's like I could literally talk for 5 straight hours about everything they lie about. Like whenever flat earthers say, you can't freely and privately explore Antarctica. Stupid flurfs say you can't go to Antarctica, and you can take a trip right now and go there.
I know. You can go there right now. It's
not being
easy.
Guarded and protected. I'm like, yeah, well, then why is this guy over here getting arrested?
Well, no. That's called, it's a lie. We don't say it's impossible to go to any part of Antarctica if you pay for an approved guided tour.
And you just go to the little edge there.
Freely and privately explore it. So that, why would you intentionally lie and say flurfs are so dumb and such liars, project the lie onto us, that they say you can't go to Antarctica? My cousin went there last week. It's like, dude, you've been corrected on that 400 times. You're going to turn around tomorrow and say it again. So why would
all
you?
All they have is strawmen. Strawmen.
Yeah, straw men's are lies, right?
Yeah. The same reason they keep saying thanks, Bob, right? They, you know, as far as they're concerned, and they're perfectly willing to take this as gospel, right? That I proved Earth rotation.
And you did, Bob. You did prove Earth rotation. But when it backfired, your test with the laser gyroscope, you doubled down and made up your own fantasies about why it showed 15 degrees per hour drift.
But as soon as I come up with an explanation for it, then I'm a complete liar.
Of course.
Yes, Bob, a liar or a fool living in his own fantasy la-la land.
But they'll believe it the other time. It's just like me. They don't ask for any of my data. They've never asked me, Bob. Not one person has said, can we see your refraction data? Can we see your level index or whatever McToon was talking about? Can we see your temperature gradient? They just accept interesting. That's all it takes.
And I gave it to them, and I didn't hear much back.
Well, then you're told they're told actually it's closer to the flat Earth prediction than the globe.
They lose,
and they'll turn around tomorrow and say, "Cheer, improved the globe."
Right. They don't even care. Right, just called
trolls. They're trolls. That's it.
Well, they're toxic, like very sad liars, right? It's like I said this before. So I think that even if you're typically a somewhat honest person, when you defend a lie, then your position is rendered a lie by default. Like whatever you say to defend it, you must be dishonest to defend the lie, because it is a lie.
Well, this is where it takes a little bit of discernment and intelligent thought from the audience, because otherwise all he's hearing is the flat earther saying they're lying about everything, and then they turn around and say, no, they're lying about everything. And, you know, what do? Well, you have to engage your brain and start thinking.
Yes, Bob, it's time to use your brain.
And they're hoping that people won't do that, because people characteristically won't.
Right, but Bob, I mean, they can watch my debate and see me with Mr. Sensible say, no one says you can't go there at all. My wife's grandparents just went there a little while back for $20,000. We're saying you can't freely and privately go there to actually go where we need to go as it pertains to this conversation. And then literally respond with, you flat earthers just lie and say you can't go there.
I know.
They can watch that, right? And be like, that's the number one email I get. I'm still looking
at what they're hoping for is somebody that is so convincing. And I'll tell you somebody that is that way. You guys know that Ruhif guy, right?
That guy could probably sell freaking ice cubes
to Eskimos. I mean, he just has this calm demeanor and this, you know, Australian accent. Everything's all cool with him. And, you know, that's what people relate to.
How cute. Bob have a problem with Ruif. The problem with Ruif for you is that he knows what he's talking about. And he always have facts behind his arguments. Try that sometime, Bob.
Oh, and I get that dude to scream and cuss and freak out and implode and rage quit like on a daily basis, bro.
Yeah, I know. So again, it takes a little thought on the audience's part as well, which, you know, that's all you can do is have faith in the audience.
So that's sad, because I was saying that to me too. She's like, dude, I'm not gonna lie. If I was new to this conversation, I went and watched MC Toon and Bryant cover you, I would think, like, wow, is this what's it guy? Like, stupid? Is he wrong about everything? Right, is he really just lying on purpose?
I feel the same way.
And that's my wife, right? She's like, it's just insane how they have no moral, like, they have no moral standard. They'll just intentionally be deceptive.
So tactically, Austin, don't you think it's
deceptive? I love it when Flat Earth is talking about moral standards. How many Flat Earth liars have we revealed? Taboo conspiracy and his F-16 pilot. Bob's 15 degrees per hour failure. And why not look at Jeremy's mistakes in the same documentary when he was showing that it was no curvature, or sorry, when he showed the curvature and didn't acknowledge it.
My opinion of that is it's because they think they're going for the truth. I really do believe that they feel that it's not a lie if your end result is people believe in the globe.
We don't believe it's a globe. We know it's a globe. Reality shows it's a globe. But when will you show any real Flat Earth evidence? A simple one? A working map. All you fools managed to prove in this video was your own ignorance and total stupidity. Once more, big thanks to all helping me sending drones to Ukraine. I have sent 14 drones and 3 power banks so far. I received the donations from $1 to $1,200. All are helping, small and big donations. If you want to help, use PayPal, link in the description. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please subscribe, become a member, or come back the next time I'm showing a video. My last video before New Year and Christmas will be tomorrow. See you then. Have a nice day.